perpendicular forces. So that kind of resolution, we call it as rectangular components of a force. And the main idea behind the resolution of force is the forces into which I have replaced, they will have the same effect as that of the original force. That was regarding resolution of force. Now, regarding the composition of force, I told you, we usually add the forces, or I can say we usually combine the forces into a force called a resultant. Now, that resultant force will be having the same effect as that of the individual force system. And I started with this simple example wherein I had two forces P and Q, and this was the force called resultant R. Now, this resultant R force is having the same as that of these two individual forces. So this process is called a composition of forces. And we also studied the parallelogram law of forces, wherein the statement goes like this: if two forces acting at a point, so the point is O, be represented in magnitude and direction by the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram drawn through that point of application, now the resultant can be completely represented, it should be represented by the diagonal of that parallelogram drawn to the same point. Now, if I represent two forces P and Q by the adjacent sides of a parallelogram, okay, where it is acting at point O, now the resultant of these two forces can be represented by the diagonal of this parallelogram, that is R, okay, and it is having this resultant force is having the same effect as that of these two individual forces P and Q. Now, how to find the magnitude of this resultant force R, and how to find out the direction of this resultant R? The direction, I mean to say, this value theta. Let alpha be the angle made by the two forces P and Q, and theta is the angle made by this resultant R with respect to P. And we derived some simple derivation, and we came to the conclusion that the magnitude of the resultant R is given by under root P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos alpha, where P and Q represent the individual forces and alpha is the angle made between them. And how to find the direction? I mean to say the angle made by the resultant with respect to P. So that is tan theta is equal to Q sin alpha divided by P plus Q cos alpha. So I can write it as theta equal to tan inverse of this, whatever we have. Right. So we ended up with our last class with this parallelogram law of forces. And in next one, we shall start with some basic numerical examples on parallelogram law of forces, right? So let me start with very, very simple numerical examples. And as the time goes, we'll come to some complicated numerical examples also. Now, the thing here, what they have asked, this is the first numerical example, this simplest of the one. The link shown in the figure below is subjected to two forces, that is F1 and F2. I can say that there is a link here. I mean to say, you can assume that this is a point. This particle or this point is subjected to two forces, F1 and F2. Now, the value of F1 is 600 newtons and the value of F2 is 400 newtons. Now, you have been asked to determine the magnitude and direction of the resultant, right? So, you have to find out what is the magnitude of the resultant, and also you need to find out what is the direction of the resultant. Now, the angle made by these two forces with respect to x-axis, that is the force, the angle made by the force F1 with respect to x-axis is 30 degree, and the angle made by force F2 with respect to y-axis is 45 degree. Now, you have to find what is the resultant of these two forces using parallelogram law of forces. Okay. Now, what shall I do here is, instead of applying directly the parallelogram law of forces, what I will do first is, I will try to find out what is the x component of this force F1, okay, and I will try to find out what is the x component of this force F2, okay. Then I will tell you what I will do in the next part. So first, let me find out what is the x component of force F1. So the x component of force F1, actually the x component will be having this direction. It means it is positive. So plus 600 cos 30. Okay. So this is the x component of the force F1. Now, similarly, I will try to find what is the x component of this force F2, and it will be having this direction. So let me write out that also. F2x. Okay. So that will be minus 400 Okay, the 45 degrees is the angle made by force F2 with respect to y-axis. So the x component will be having sine component now. Sine 45. And one more thing, simple tip I want to give you. Whenever it is 45 degree, don't worry about cos or sine. Okay, you apply anything. Because cos 45 is equal to sine 45. So this value comes out to be plus 519.6 newtons, and this value comes out to be minus 282.8 newtons. Now with this, what I will do, I will try to find out what is the net force in x direction, right? So I will find out what is the net force in x direction. Now you can see that this is positive and this is negative. So I will write it as plus 519.6 minus 282.8. So this comes out to be plus 236.76 newtons. So you're getting positive. It means that the net force in x direction, as per our sign convention, is actually in this direction, right? Next, what I will do, I will try to find out what is the y component of this force, which will be in this direction, and the y component of this force, which will be in this direction. So let us try to find out that also. So y component of force F1, which is equal to, and it will be plus because it is in the upward direction, plus 600 sine 30, okay? And the y component of force F2, which will be also positive because it is in the upward direction, and that will be 400 cos 45. So this value, I will get it as plus 300 newtons. And this one, I'm getting it as plus 282.8 newtons. And both you are getting positive. It means that both are in the upward direction. So I will try to find out what is the net force in y direction, which is equal to plus 300 newtons plus 282.2, okay, which I will get it as plus 582.8. Okay, since you are getting positive, it means your net force in y direction is also upwards, right? So now similarly, if I take that point O, okay, so the net force at point O in x direction is now acting in this direction. Okay, so this is the net force at point O in x direction, and the net force at point O in y direction is also, it is in the upward direction, right? So this value we have already found out, which is plus 236.76, and this value is also we have found out plus, that is plus 582.8 newtons. Okay, right? Now you can see here we have two forces, Fx and Fy, which are acting mutually perpendicular to each other. So from this, I can say that the resultant will be in this direction. And what will be the value of this resultant and what will be the angle made by this resultant, that we have to find. Now for this diagram, I can easily apply the parallelogram law of forces instead of this kind of a diagram, right? Because now you can see your alpha is 90 degree. That is the, what is alpha actually? Alpha is the angle made by the two forces, and the angle made by the two forces is 90 degree. And what will be your P? P will be nothing but Fx. Okay. And what will be your Q? And Q will be nothing but Fy. So you know this, you know this, and you know this, and you know the formula to find the resultant of two forces as the parallelogram law of forces. Let me just write down that formula here again. So it is under the root p square plus q square plus 2pq cos alpha. Okay, so I can just write it as, so p is nothing but fx, okay, is this 236.76 square, and fy is 582.8 square plus 2pq, that is 2 into 236.76 multiplied by 582.8 multiplied by cos alpha. Alpha is 90 degree, we know that. And you can see here, what will be the value of cos 90? Cos 90 will be 0. So if this becomes 0, this whole term will be 0, right? Then I can find out the value of resultant, as it is coming out to be 629 newtons. Okay, it is coming out to be 629 newtons. That is the magnitude of the resultant R. Now we also need to find out what is the angle made by this R with respect to fx, that is the direction of R, and we know the formula for that also. So that is theta equal to tan inverse of, we have already find out that formula, q sine alpha divided by p plus q cos alpha. Okay, now you know q, you know p, you know q, and you know alpha also. And once you substitute that, you will get the value of theta, as I have found out, it comes out to be 67.9 degrees. Okay, students, now you can unmute yourself, and you have any queries in this numerical example? Students, are you having any queries?
Sir, can I ask?
Yes.
So how did you find out that XOY is 90 degree?
Which one?
No, sir, you say FY is 582.8 Newton and FX is 236.75 Newton. Mm-hmm. How did you find out it has an angle, alpha has the angle of 90 degree?
See, you can see, just see here. This is my F1X, okay, and this is my F2X, right? So F1X minus F2X, you should get in this fashion itself, that is, this is FX, and this is my F1Y, and this is my F2Y, okay? So this also you should get it in this fashion itself. And since these two forces are concurrent forces, so the net forces also should be concurrent. They cannot be non-concurrent, right? Okay, since these two forces are actually concurrent, so your component of the forces, that is Fx and Fy, also should be concurrent. So it should be 90 degree.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Any doubts? Other students, any doubts?
F2AX and F2Y again, sir.
Yes.
Can you explain the F2X and F2Y?
See, F2X, right? So it is the X component of this force F2, and the direction of that will be in this direction. So I'm putting it as minus. So minus 400. Okay, now what is the angle made by F2 with respect to Y axis? It is 45 degree. So the X component of F2 will be actually sine. So it is sine 45, right? And F2Y, if I come. So F2Y, so it is in this direction. So I'm putting it as plus. And the value is 400 cos 45. Why cosine component has come in Y axis? Because the angle made by the force with respect to Y is 45 degree. That's why the cosine component has come. Clear?
Okay, sir.
Yes. Students, any other doubts?
No, sir.
So any other doubts you have, students?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So we cannot do this directly with the parallelogram formula.
Yes. So if no doubts are there, shall I proceed? Shall I proceed, students? Yes, yeah, with the next numerical. Yes, yeah. Okay, right. Let me come to this numerical example. This is second numerical example. A little twist is there in this numerical example. I can say it as a twist. Okay, it is just imagination point. Now you have to determine the magnitude and direction of the resultant force measured counterclockwise from positive x-axis. Okay, so what is that counterclockwise and how to find out that? I will explain you. Right. First thing is there are two forces which are acting at this point. That is F1 and F2. Okay, so you need to find out the resultant magnitude of the resultant and direction of that. And you just note down. This axis is x-axis now and this axis is y-axis. You can interchange, right? So no hard and fast rule that always your horizontal should be x and vertical should be y. Okay, so here also what I will do, I will try to find out the x and y component of force F1 and F2, right? So let me just do that. So first let me find out the x component of this force F1, right? So how will be the x component now? See here, this is your x-axis now. So the x component of this force F1, will it be like this or will it be like this? Okay, obviously it should be like this. This is the x component of force F1 and this is the y component of force F1. Now similarly here also, this will be the y component. This will be the y component of force F2 and this will be the x component of force F2. Why it is happening like is, see here, x component should be always parallel to the x-axis and the y component should be always parallel to the y-axis. So this is the x component of force F2 and this is the y component of force F2, right? So let us find the x and y components. So I will try to find first the x component, F1x. Okay, so I'm trying to find actually this one. So you can see here the angle made by this force F1 is with respect to y-axis. So the x component will come sine component. So, and you can see the F1x is actually in the positive x-axis. You can see this is actually the positive x-axis and this is actually the positive y-axis. So you should get it as plus 400. Sine 30. So this comes out to be plus 200 newtons. Okay, then similarly the x component of force F2, right? You can see the x component of force F2 is also in this direction itself. That is, it is in the same direction as that of the positive x-axis. But what is the angle made by force F2 with respect to x-axis? It is 45 degree. So you will get a cosine component there. So it should be 250 cos 45. This comes out to be plus 176.77. Students, you can unmute yourself now. So are you clear with this?
So could you tell me how coordinates here?
Yeah, see here. I will explain once again. This is positive y-axis. Okay. And this is positive x-axis. And if it comes on this side, it is negative y-axis. And if it comes on this side, it is negative x-axis. Right? So this side, if you go, it is negative x-axis, and if this side you've come, it is positive x-axis, and this side if you come, it is positive y-axis, and this side if you come, it is negative y-axis, right? Okay, now after this, you can see here, this is force F1 and this is force F2. The x component of this force F1, that is, this is x-axis, right? So the x component of this force F1 will be in this direction itself, because you can see here, if this is your force, okay, so the, let me just do it some different color, right? See, this is your y-axis and this is your x-axis, okay? And this is actually the force F1, right? And if you try to draw the x component of this one, that is x component of this force F1, it will be in this direction itself. And if you try to draw the y component, it will be in this direction. So you can see here, the x component of this force F1 is in the positive x-axis. So the x component will be positive. And you also, you can see the y component of this force F1 is also in the positive y-axis. That's why it will be positive. Are you clear, students? Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
This is how I can find the component of these, the x component of force F1 and F2. Now, if I try to find out the net force in x direction, I will try to find net force in x direction. So both are positive. So you are bound to get a positive answer. So plus 200 plus 176.77. So you will get plus 376.77 newtons, right? Okay, so this is the net force in x direction. Now let me try to find out what is the y component of force F1. You can see here, where is the y component? Yeah, here, the y component of force F1. Again, you can see this is also in the positive y axis, so it should be plus. So plus 400 into cos 30. So this comes out to be plus 346.4. Okay, then I will try to find the y component of force F2, and you can see here, this is the y component, and you can see this is in this direction. It means it is in the negative y axis. So you should write minus 250. Okay, the angle made by this force with respect to x axis is 45. So the y component will become sine 45. So this comes out to be minus 176.77. Okay, now I can find the net force in y direction. So plus 346.4 minus 176.77. So this comes out to be plus 170 newtons. Is that okay, students? Is it okay?
So decimal is not there.
Which decimal?
FY.
Yeah, 346.4 minus 176.77. So 169.63 it is coming. So I'm taking it as 170 newtons.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Any doubts, students, in this?
No, sir.
Okay. Right. Now I want to find what is the. Yes.
So shouldn't it be plus 176.7? Because minus of minus we have to take, right?
Which one? FI or FX?
FI.
See, FI it is 346.4 minus 176.77. You are getting 169.
Both are. So, okay, sir. So got it.
Okay, got it? Okay, yeah. So any doubts, students?
No, sir.
Okay, right. Now let me just write down these axes once again so that it will be easy for me to make you understand about how will be the resultant, right? Let me just draw that. So this will be your x-axis, and this is actually your y-axis. Sorry, this is y-axis, and this is x-axis, and it is in the positive direction. This is also in the positive direction, and this is y-axis with the negative direction, and this is your x in the negative direction, right? Okay, now let me mark this. So fx is plus 376.77, which is in the x direction. So in x direction towards positive, you have to mark. So if I try to mark towards positive, it will be like this. So, sorry. So this will be your fx. Similarly, you are getting fy also positive. Okay, it means in the positive direction you have to mark. So this will be your fy, right? And the resultant will be actually in between this. So it might be something like this. It might be something like this. So this will be your resultant, right? Okay. So if you do like this, so you can say this as say P, and you can assume this as Q. Okay, you can assume P and Q interchange also. Interchange also can be done. And this will be the angle made by the two things. And this will be theta. This is alpha, which is 90 degree, and theta you need to find. So you need to find theta and you need to find R. Now I can easily use once again the parallelogram law of forces. So R is equal to square root of P square plus Q square. So the next term I'm not writing, that is P plus 2PQ cos alpha, because alpha is 90 degree. So cos alpha will be zero. So that third term will become zero. So I can write this as, so P is FY and Q is FX. Okay, you can substitute these values, and let me substitute them. 170 square. That is FY, and Q is 376.77 square. So you'll get the resultant force as 413.3 newtons. This is the resultant, that is the magnitude of the resultant. Now I also need to find what is the direction. Direction, I mean to say theta, the angle made by R with respect to P. That is theta is equal to tan inverse of Q sine alpha divided by P plus Q cos alpha. So I will write Q sine alpha divided by 2 plus P, P plus Q. P plus Q cos alpha. If you substitute the value of Q as fx and P as fy and alpha equal to 90 degree, so you'll get this angle as theta equal to 17.27 degrees. Is that clear, students?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Yeah. Yes. Any doubts?
No, sir.
No?
No, sir.
Yeah. So this is how you have to be very careful when the axes have been rotated, right? So the calculation part is very, very simple, but imagining which is X and which is Y axis, and seeing the angles made by the forces with respect to which axis and taking properly with the cosine and sine components, that plays a very important role. The further calculation, that is the mathematics part, anybody can do. But writing this x component and y component becomes very, very important, right? And you also should see the x and y axis very, very carefully. Are you clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.
Let me move to the next numerical example. Yeah. Yes, okay. Now here, if theta equal to 60 degree, that is this angle is given as 60 degree, and F equal to 450 newtons, that is this value, F equal to 450 newtons, determine the magnitude of the resultant force. I missed one thing in the previous example. So what actually he had asked is, determine the magnitude. So magnitude we have already found out. And direction of the resultant force measured counterclockwise from x-axis. Okay, that actually he has asked. So counterclockwise means anticlockwise. Okay, clockwise is one, and the opposite word is counterclockwise or anticlockwise. You can whether anything you can say. So your clockwise will be in this direction, and your anticlockwise will be in this direction, right? Now here I will come. So if this is the resultant, okay, in between these two forces, so this he is actually asking counterclockwise from x-axis. So if I measure the direction of the resultant, that is the angle made by the resultant with respect to the x-axis, okay, with respect to x-axis, so from if I measure from x to r, if I measure from x to r, okay, this is the angle made by the resultant with respect to x-axis in the counterclockwise direction. Okay, I will repeat once again. This is the angle made by the resultant with respect to x-axis in the counterclockwise direction. But actually we have found this angle, but what he has asked, he has actually asked this angle. So how can I find that? So let me call that as phi. So phi is simply 90 minus theta. So which comes out to be 90 minus 17.27, which comes out to be 72.73. Are you clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so always read out what actually they have asked.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, in this case, alpha is 90 degrees, so we told that it is 90 minus theta. But if alpha is not 90 degrees, that time we have to take alpha minus theta.
Yes, alpha minus theta. Yes, correct. So whatever alpha value you will get, so alpha minus theta you have to take. But okay, you see here, most of the numerical examples, whenever we solve, we usually try to find out what is the net force in y direction and what is the net force in x direction, right? So when we do that, always the angle between them will come out to be 90 degree itself.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so it will not cross 90 degree, or it will not be less than 90 degree.
Okay, sir.
You can see here. Yeah, you can see here. Actually, that was a good question. You can see here. So this angle we don't know actually.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so it could be anything. It could be more than 90 or less than 90. But we made sure that the components of F1 and F2, that is in X and Y, are coming out to be 90 degree itself.
Okay.
Okay, so that's why always it will be 90 degree itself.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, let me go for the next numerical example. Okay, so here the angle theta is given as 60 degree, and the force F is given as 450 newtons, and you need to determine the magnitude of the resultant force and its direction measured counterclockwise from positive x-axis. Okay, counterclockwise from positive x-axis. Now you can see here, so x is given like this. Okay, so this will be always the positive x-axis. Okay, and y is given like this. So this will be always the positive y-axis, and this will be always the negative x-axis, and this will be always the negative y-axis, right? So you need to find out the magnitude of the resultant and its direction measured counterclockwise from positive x-axis. Let us move and try to find out them. Okay, what I will do, let me call this as say F1 equal to 450 newtons. Okay, and I will call this as say F2 equal to 700 newtons. And I will try to find out the x and y components of F1 and F2. So the x component of F1 will be in this direction, that is, this will be F1x, and the x component of F2 will be actually in this direction. So that will be F2x. So let us try to find out them. So F1x will be, and it is in this direction, so it should be always positive, positive 450. And what is the angle made by F1 with respect to x-axis? It is given as 60 degree. So you will get cosine component, cos 60. So this comes out to be 450 into cos of 60. So you will get it as plus 225 newtons. Okay. Then similarly, F2x as, okay, and it is in this direction, you can see. So you'll get minus 700. And the angle made by F2 with respect to x-axis is 15 degrees. So once again, you will get a cosine component. So 700 into cos of 15, you'll get it as minus 76.14. So you can get the net force in x direction as plus 225 minus 676.14. So you will end up with the negative answer. So plus 225 minus 676.14, you will get it as minus 451.14. 451.14 newtons. It means you are getting minus sign. It means the fx is in this direction, right? So similarly, let us try to find out the y components of F1 and F2. So the y component of F1 will be in this direction. So this will be F1y, and the y component of F2 will be in this direction. So this will be F2y. So I'll find the y component of F1, which is F1y is equal to, and it is in the upward direction, so it is positive. So 450, and the angle made by F1 with respect to x is 60 degree. So I should take here sine 60 degree. So 450 into sine 60, you will get it as plus 389.71. Newtons. And F2y, you can see it is downwards, so you should write it as minus. So minus 700 sine 15. Okay, 700 into sine of 15. So you'll get it as minus 181.17. Okay. Now let me find out what is the net force in y direction. So Fy will be equal to plus 389.71 minus 181.17. You will get it as 389.71 minus 181.17. You will get it as plus 208.54. And you're getting positive sign. It means the total force in y direction is like this. Okay. Now let me mark them. This is your fx, fx is in this direction, you can see here. So I should put it in the other way. So this is your fx, that is the net force in x direction. And this is your fy, that is net force in y direction. So this is fx and this is fy. So the resultant will be in between them, something like this. This will be your resultant. So this is the angle made by the resultant with respect to fx. Okay, you can assume this as say p, and you can assume this as say q. Yes, till now any doubts, students? Any doubts we have, students?
Sir, it's from counterclockwise, no sir?
Yes. So that I will measure. That I will measure. I will take now theta, then I will measure how it will be.
Okay, sir. So, but if we do directly, then it is possible, no sir?
So directly, it is actually not possible because as per the statement goes, theta is actually the angle made by resultant with respect to P. Okay, so that you can find first, then you can find the other direction.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, let me proceed further and find out the value of the resultant. So resultant will be P square plus Q square. So P is fx and Q is fy. So let me substitute them. So fx square is fx, that is minus 451.14 square. If you make, it will be plus. Okay, 451.14 square plus 208.54 square. Okay, and if you take the square root of that, you will get 497 newtons. The magnitude of the resultant is 497 newtons. Okay, and the angle made by them, that is theta equal to tan inverse of Q. Q is Fy, that is 208.54 sine of alpha is 90 degree divided by P. P is actually Fx, which is 451.14. Now here you can see, so I'm not actually taking minus sign, right? I will explain you why I'm not taking minus sign here. 451.14 P plus Q. Q is once again 208.54 into sine alpha. P plus Q cos alpha it is. Cos of 90. Okay. So this value comes out to be, let me just calculate that, 451.14 plus 208.54 into cos of 90 by 208.54 into sine of 90. So I'll make inverse of that. So tan inverse of answer. So 31.87 degrees. Okay, I'm getting it as 31.87 degrees. Now let me explain you why I have not taken minus sign here. But as per the thing goes, I should take minus sign. But why I have not taken the minus sign? You can see here, this minus sign is actually giving you only the direction. Okay, only the direction. Algebraically, you should not take minus sign whenever you consider them in the formula. Okay, minus sign indicates you only the direction. So you should not take that minus sign here. If you take minus sign, you will go wrong. Right, so don't take minus sign whenever you're actually calculating the angle made by the resultant. Okay. Yes. Any doubts? Any doubts, students?
No, sir.
No? Okay. So actually what he has asked you the measured counterclockwise from the positive x-axis. Counterclockwise means it is in this direction, right? But we have actually measured here from here to here. That is in the clockwise direction we have measured. But he actually wants, that is, this is x-axis. He wants the angle made by the resultant with respect to x-axis in the counterclockwise direction. That is this angle he wants. So that, let me call that as say phi. So I can get the value of phi as 180 minus theta. So 180 minus 31.87, which comes out to be 148.13. Is that clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, any doubts are there? I'm going to end the class now. So few more numerical examples I have. So I will take them in my next class.
So it should be 90 minus theta, no, sir?
How it will be 90 minus theta?
So
you actually have to measure the angle made by the resultant with respect to positive x-axis measured in the counterclockwise direction. This angle is measured in the clockwise direction, but you actually want this angle. So this, how much is this total angle? 180 degree. Out of that, this much you know. So 180 minus theta.
Thank you, sir.
Any other doubts, students?
No, sir.